Welcome to Lou Designs. I'm Lou and I'm a self-taught graphic designer. In this channel, I share easy-to-follow Canva and graphic design tips for non-designers who want to design their own graphics but ends up spending hours in Canva, which led to feeling overwhelmed and ends up not designing anything at all. If that's you, be sure to subscribe and tap the bell icon so you'll be notified when I upload a new video. Woo! I'm going to share with you a step-by-step tutorial on how to create or design a fillable or interactive workbook in Canva, because there are two types of workbook user. Workbook user A are the traditional type. They are people who love to print and fill out the workbook using a pen or a pencil. Workbook user B, on the other hand, are the all things digital type. They want to save the trees or they want to save Mother Earth. They just don't have a printer, or for whatever reasons, they prefer filling out their workbook in the computer itself. I created this video with workbook user B in mind. So without further ado, here's the tutorial. First of all, you need to be signed into your Canva account. So this is a web version of Canva. There are also mobile and desktop app versions of Canva. But for me, this is the easiest version to design a workbook. So let's use this for now. Step one is to create a blank document. So in order to do that, in the upper right corner of your screen, select Create a Design. The size of your workbook is really up to you, but the most common sizes are A4 document and a US letter document. Let's use A4 document. And now you have your blank canvas. Step two is to search for Canva templates to be used for our workbook design. So we don't have to design from scratch. We'll use beautiful templates from Canva's wide library and then modify them later to suit the style that we want to achieve. So in the search bar, let us search for workbook since we are going to design a workbook. And then find templates that appeals to you the most. Don't overthink your design just yet. In this stage, we are just doing or arranging the page layout of your workbook. Just add some parts of templates that you like, and then we're going to modify them later. When you hover your mouse pointer over the template, you can see that the number of pages are shown, like this one. It has 5 pages. And when you click this, you can see a bigger preview. Select the pages that appeals to you the most. I wanted also to add a table of contents page. So let's add a page after our cover. And on the templates, let's search for table of contents. Let's look for a simple one. Okay, and now you have a 6-page workbook with different styles. Next is to add the text content in your workbook. So I suggest having your text ready or your copy ready in a word processing software or Google Docs, like the lead magnet guide that I created. I already have the content in a Google Doc. In this corner, you have an outline. It's easier to visualize what you want your layout to be in Canva. If your copy or your text content is not ready yet, and you are so excited to design in Canva, or you prefer designing your workbook first to spark an idea, my tip is to use a dummy text generator. Go to blindtextgenerator.com/lorem-ipsum, and then you can just copy this dummy texts to your templates. So let's try this. Now that we've added the text to our workbook, next step is to make the colors and fonts of all these pages cohesive. We need to do this so that our workbook design will be pleasing to the eye of the reader. So there are two ways to do this faster. One is to have a brand kit. A brand kit is only available to Canva Pro users, so you can find them
here in your homepage, Canva homepage. A brand kit includes all your brand colors and your brand fonts, so that when you design and you want to change your fonts and colors, you can just select your brand kit. Another method, if you don't have a brand kit, is to use the styles feature of Canva. So just click the styles icon here, and then you can find different styles available in Canva. Click anything in the page and then select the style that you want to copy. So as you've noticed, it automatically replaced the existing style that we have. Let's use this one. Let's do this for the other pages. You can also shuffle the colors by hovering your mouse to that style and clicking shuffle. Or you could also copy the style of the other page by clicking the thing you want to copy and then clicking the copy style icon, paste the style to the element that you want. When you're done styling your workbook, you can select the grid view here to see how your overall lookbook looks like. You can make necessary adjustments if you're not very satisfied with the look and feel of your workbook. Also add your website in the footer, or you can also add a copyright to have like an indication of your ownership to the workbook. You can just copy that and paste that to other pages. The positioning would be the same with how it is positioned on the page that you copy it from. When you're satisfied with the colors and fonts and layout of your workbook, you can now add design elements and stock photos to make your workbook more lively and exciting. This step is optional. It's really up to you if you want to add stock photos and design elements to your workbook, but keeping it simple is also great. Again, it's really up to you, but I know that finding the right stock photos and design elements are usually the main time suckers when designing in Canva. So let me show you how to find cohesive stock photos easily and faster. Select photos. If you have a specific thing that you're looking for or that you have in mind, just search here in the search bar. But if you don't have any idea of what stock photos to use yet, you can find a lot of amazing photos here on trending. My suggestion is to use photos that has colors similar or almost the same with the colors found in your workbook pages. So this one is a great example. We can try this one. Oh, and I think it looks good. To find photos similar to that, hover your mouse pointer in that photo, click this three-dot icon, select View More by this creator. Because when you click that, you can find all the photos uploaded by that specific creator. Therefore, they have the same vibe, so that's one thing. The other tip is to copy the color code of any object from your workbook. Copy the code and then you can filter here and click the plus icon and paste the code here and click apply filters. Now you can only find photos that has the same or almost the same color with this one. Now for the elements. So to elements, let's try abstract. Select graphics tab so that all the result would be just purely graphics. Find the elements that you like. So this one, for example, and then you can change the color to something like that. Another tip is again to select the three-dot icon and select the creator, and you can find all related objects uploaded by the creator. For me, the existing elements in this workbook are great already. So let's just copy this and paste this to other pages. After we're finished designing our workbook, let me show you how to add links to them. My suggestion is to add page title for each of these pages So let's add the title cover here, table of contents. Let's name this exercise one. Next is, let's add a link to this website so that when your reader click this, they will be redirected to your website link. So this is not a real website, let's just assume that it is. So let's copy the URL and then click the text and select this link icon. So click that and paste the URL and hit enter in your keyboard. So as you've noticed, there is automatically an underline to that. So if you don't want to have an underline, simply click this underline icon over here. You don't have to do this to all of the footer. You can just simply copy this and paste them to the other pages. So you see the link is also copied. Now we also want to link our table of contents to other pages for easy navigation to our reader. So what we're going to do is click this one, add the link, and instead of adding a URL, you can just select which page in this document you want that to be linked to. So this one, for example, is exercise one. That's why it's very important to add titles to your pages here to select the anchor links faster. So you just click that and select exercise one. You can select them all and deselect underline. Once you're happy with everything, it's now time to download your workbook. So to do that, just click the button share and download. Then for the file type, there are two options, PDF standard and PDF print. Now, if you want to print the workbook, it is recommended to use this file type. But since we want the workbook to be used digitally, let's just use PDF standard. It's smaller in size, but it works for the digital type of files. We select all the pages and click download. Let's try this one. See, we are redirected to exercise one. Let's try exercise four. Okay, it's working. Finally, it's time to make our workbook fillable. So we're going to use a free tool called PDFEscape. So just go to pdfescape.com, select free online, and then select upload PDF to PDFEscape. You can drop your workbook here or select this button, choose file, and look for the workbook we've created. Let's find the pages where we want the fields to be or the areas to be fillable. We want our readers or the workbook users to type inside this box. So in this area, let's select form field, and there's a lot to choose from. There's text, there's text paragraph, checkbox, radio button, drop down, and so on. Select text paragraph and then select and drag your mouse to the area where you want to be fillable. Next, you can change the font style and size of your form field. Select Verdana for now. And you can preview how it would look like here by double clicking. And you can also adjust the size and the font weight. You can also change the color. When this is still selected and you click anywhere here, the form field that you select before would still be the same, even the style. So you don't have to select the form field again and select the text paragraph, but you can just simply drag your mouse and the style will be copied. Now let's disable adding form field by clicking here Okay, so now it's disabled. You can delete the form field by clicking the form field and clicking this trash icon over here, delete object. Another way is to right click and duplicate the text field or the text form field and adjust it. And you can do that to other parts of your workbook also. Repeat the process of adding form fields and dragging your mouse. Once you're done adding the form fields, save this by clicking the save button here and download by clicking this icon here. Now let's try our fillable workbook. And now you can type anything here, and let's try this one. Now you have a fillable interactive workbook.
And that is how you create or design an interactive or fillable workbook in Canva and PDFEscape. If you find this video helpful, please share this with your friends and comment below if you have any questions or suggestions. Don't forget to subscribe and tap the bell icon so you'll be notified when I upload a new video. I hope you got a lot of aha moments in this tutorial. See you in the next one!